Dear class 7th, this is geography and we'll be discussing case studies in this video. This is the case studies of the chapter 7, that is Europe, right? Now children, before I go ahead with this part of the video, let me make you understand that what does case studies mean. Now case studies is actually investigation of a particular country in depth. Okay, so many data are gathered from a variety of sources and then a deep study of a particular country is done. So similar has been done over here. So we have been studying Europe. Now Switzerland is a mountainous Central European country, right? And first of all, you should know that what is the capital of Switzerland. As we're studying Switzerland, you should know the capital of Switzerland is Bern. What is the capital of Switzerland? Bern, right? Next children, as we said, that Switzerland is a mountainous Central European country and it is home to numerous lakes. Home to numerous lakes means that it has many lakes. It's a place where there are many lakes, villages and high peaks of the Alps. Alps is a mountain system, right? Then find the soaring means very high snow-capped peaks of the Alps. Glittering blue lakes, glittering means sparkling blue lakes are also found over here with emerald valleys. What is emerald? Emerald refers to, emerald is actually a very precious stone. Okay, it is bright green color. But then what does it represent? Emerald valleys represent an area which is, you know, green and beautiful, which, you know, represents healing and healing quality and fertility all around. So actually these words are used to describe the place called Switzerland. So this place has glaciers, picturesque lakeside hamlets imbue this landlocked nation with a fairy tale beauty. What does it mean? That this is when we talk about Switzerland, it is a landlocked country. As we know, what a landlocked country, it's a landlocked nation which is surrounded by land from all the sides, right? And it's this place is has a beauty like that of a fairy tale. Okay, in fairy tale stories and all, you must have seen a beautiful place described with so many mountains, rivers, glaciers, you know, some picturesque atmosphere. So this place is similar. It's actually a, you know, living, or you can say, you can see with your open, you can see this place with your eyes. You can, it appears as if a fairy tale land is right in front of you. So because of its beauty, this place has become a place of tourist attraction. So every year people come here, people all over the world come here for many, you know, sports, for enjoyments. Then you find that this place is best for ski resorts and hiking, right? And over here, so within the top 25 destinations in the world, and this Switzerland accounts for 10 million of all tourists as of 2002, as I told you. So when in case study, actually the data is collected to study a particular place in a deep manner, right? So many, and next, many more informations are given over here. That Switzerland is, though it is a small country, how small it is? It is slightly smaller than US states of New Hampshire and Vermont. If you combine these two states, United States, this has these two places named New Hampshire and Vermont. If you combine these places, this Switzerland is even smaller than this. But it has a lot of unlimited range of geography, history and scenic attraction. It's so beautiful. So that is why this place is attracts many tourists all around the world, right? And this is one of the prime reason of tourist arrival in Switzerland. Then you'll just, there are many parks, natural parks available over here. The southern part of this region is, has alpine region, has mountains and all. But then in the northern part of this region, you'll find that there are more agriculture areas, right? Then just learn the names of these parks mentioned over here. Park Ella, the regional nature, Cantrish. Okay. Then we have some oldest park in Switzerland. Okay. That also you should know, which is the oldest park in Switzerland. That is the regional nature, Cantrish. Then the Swiss national park, it is also known as Graubünden. Okay. So just go through all this. Up till here we'll do in this video. In the next video we'll continue.